All right. I don't know how many parts this is going to be, but we're still working on the chassis here. I have determined that we are going to be building a high watt type amplifier for this series. Just because they don't make kits for them. And every kit that's out there, like Weber makes a kit and it's highly inaccurate. It's not even close. This is not going to be a high watt, guys. It's going to be different. But it's going to be very close. I'm going to build this one. We're going to do KT88s with this one. So I'm not using the L34s like high watt did. So right there in its general sense, it's not going to be a high watt. I'm going to use the fundamentals from high watt, and I'm going to also probably do, it's either going to be a late 60s or an early 70s. But anyway, let's get right to it. First thing that we need to do is we have our caliper. We measure. We're going to measure the distance between here and here, which is 3 inches. So we're going to go to 1.5 inches. And then we're going to just score a line right down the center. And I'm going to do that on the back side too. Right now we don't have a back side or a front side. Here input, because our inputs are on this side and our power switch is going to be over here. So very first thing that we do here is I took these inputs apart. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to determine the width of my jack. I got to unsolder all these because I'm going to reuse them again. But it's looking like the width of it is, it's right around 3/4 of an inch. And the height of it, let's just say that it's an inch. It's not an inch, it's a 0.9, but I'm gonna go an inch. So I'm gonna go an inch, probably an inch by an inch by 0.850. So anyway, I know that when I build my box, I'm gonna need space. But I also know this. We have to put potentiometers in this thing too as well. We have to put power, a lot of things that we have to do here. We have to put power switches. That in there. So let's get a piece of paper. And let's determine the circuit first. So look, I'm gonna draw this out. Let's bring this up. Hold on, guys. Let me lift this up here so you can see what's going on. It's important stuff. We're gonna have inputs, and then we're gonna have our pre-gain one. So pre-one, pre-two, we have bass, mid, treble, presence, and master. Make sure. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're going to be using a total of 7 pots. And then over here, we're going to have our pilot light. then we're gonna have our switches are on, our standby. So we have to fit all this on the face of there. Get this over here and so you can see what's happening. These are your inputs. I'm gonna write it down. So we have our inputs. We have our gain one, gain two, bass, mid, treble, presence, master, pilot light, standby and on switch. Get this so you can see it. All right, so let's just do this for a second. Let's take some pots. Lay it around. I don't even know if that's going to be possible with this size chassis. It's going to be tight. It's going to be tight in there. Idea, dude, of components. I'm just putting the components up here. Here's my other one. All right. So I'm assuming this is where I'm determining. This is where I'm determining. I'm determining I want my one inputs to start here and my other ones to start here. All right. And I want my first pot to be here. And I want a space of my pots ...1.87 inches. So let's go 1.80 is fine. So what I'm going to do is just come on my line that I have here, make a mark, make another mark, make another mark. Let's make sure that they're not accurate. Piece of metal in my sock and it hurts. That motherfucker, dude, was stabbing me in the toe. Alright, so the first one we have is perfect there. I'm trying to keep my hands out of the way, guys. Alright, so look. Keep line. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So we know that this line right here to here is exactly 1.5. So let's go between 1.5 inches. It's gonna be 3/4 inch, right? So if we put our calipers, 3/4 inch. 0.750. If we go from the top, and that's going to be right at this line, that I wanted it. And this is where you want to be accurate. Because you'll see all these holes. And then from the bottom, we're going to do the same thing, 3/4 of an inch up. And then, remember I determined that I wanted my, I don't know, I don't think that 3/4 of an inch is going to be good. Because it looks like it's just not a lot of room to leave a lot of lettering when we want to print. But if we look, I have my spacing a lot tighter on this one. So what we could probably get away with is, let's just say 1 inch on center. Let's do 1 inch. So what I'm going to do here now is that line where I wanted it. Didn't mark from the edge. This line. You know what I'll do? I'll just lock it and then I'll just score it. And then I'll come to this next one and do the same thing. I'm not gonna edit these videos anymore. I'm sick and tired of it. All right. So what we've done is, remember I just laid that out there. I decided that's where I wanted to put them. I still have some space on the edge to build my cab lip. I'm gonna go 1 inch. I want the spacing to be 1 inch from the top and 1 inch from the bottom on center. I think that'll be good. Now these are cliff jacks. You can get them from most stores. You can use any jack if you want. I use cliff jacks. But let's look here. It's looking fairly like what I had the other one set up at. So I crossed that line. So right there. They're gonna be the input holes. These are all your pot holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we're gonna do our pilot lamp. So where do I want it? That's the question. And I'm thinking, remember you have to compensate for your, if you're gonna use chicken knobs for these things. I don't have one with me, but I'm not using chicken knobs. I'll use these purple ones this time. So I got plenty, I would have plenty enough room in between the pots. You see, just making sure that, I mean, I could space them out a little bit more and give me a little bit more space. I might do that, actually. This is a part of designing the amplifier. So I was sitting at, let's just try to do, let's see here. Let's try to do 1.5 inch spacing. That's pretty good. So I don't want to move this one. This one is going to stay. But this one. I'm going to put a circle on it. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that might be too much. Might be thick. Yeah, see, that's going to be too much. So that's not going to work neither. Ah. I'm just gonna break it down to you real fast. I don't do this usually. I usually lay everything out inside my program. I haven't done it this way in years. So, it's already been 16 minutes and we've gotten nowhere. See what I'm talking about, time? See, when people buy amplifiers, they don't realize how much time really goes into one, the thought. I just wanted to get rid of those marks so that we didn't start over. All right, so we were at 1.5 and that was way too much. So we're not gonna do a 1.5. And a 1-inch was too little. I think is that where we were at before? It was a 1.1. So we're going to do 1.25. It looks like 1.25 is probably going to be where we're going to live. So 1.250. It's going to be our home. I mean, the first one worked, but they're a little close. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Circle these because that's where they're just gonna live. Just period. And the spacing was 0.250. It was 1.25 inches in between center. So now if we look at our, where these would be, that's pretty good. They're you have a lot of room in between your thumb and finger to grab it and turn it. So we're good. Next thing to do is we're gonna take this and we're gonna just place this away from it. So I'm assuming I like it there. That's where I think I want it. You could take your knob and align your knob up with center and put that up there and see if you're gonna run into it, but I'm not gonna run into it. So I'm assuming I like it here. This is where I want it, right there. And then this one is gonna go right here. And this one, I'll go right here. But that gives us a problem. All right, what is the problem? Can you guys see what the problem is? Because there's a problem. I want to maintain the distance between center pot and X, or zero, and zero and last one the same. So if we look, we're sitting at 1.25. So we're gonna come here, we're gonna make a mark. This is definitely where I want this one. All right, that gives me an equal amount of space in between. So that means my next one has to be, get away with it quite a bit. right here. Right here. I want this one right here. And then just make sure that it has enough room. So our bracket's gonna be here. It's gonna make sure there's enough room away from this switch to live. And I'm assuming right here is where I want it. We'll erase all this stuff after I'm done. I'm gonna paint it all anyway. So the first thing that we wanna do is we wanna take our calipers, and this is the jewel that's gonna fit over top of your light. So this is the size of the hole. This ain't the hole. This is so we're gonna measure this. It's gonna be 0.6. We're gonna just do a little bigger. 0.7 is perfect. So this is gonna be 0.700. All right. This one is gonna be 0.475, and this will be 0.475 as well. The pots are going to probably be 0.36. So 0.36. 0.36. And then last but least, take our clip jacks, take one of them off, take the spacers off. We're going to measure. We're gonna measure this hole. It's 0.5, I don't know, 0.47. So all these holes right here, 0.47. And let's see here. And I think that's it. I don't think that there's anything else that I have to do. This is not a high watt. Again, the chassis is already different. Our layout's already different. I mean, you can go find the exact dimensions if you wanted to and try to do one, but why? Dude, do them your own way. That's the best way to do it. But I think as of right now, we're not done. So on these pots, we have a little pin, all right? So let me show you something. So these are gonna come through here, through the backside. I gotta look to see what orientation I wanna do these things at, because I totally forgot. So looking at it, like, let's take a look. I want my pots to face downward, I do believe. I do believe that's the way I want them to. I don't want them to face up. Oh yeah, I want my pots to face down. Like this. I don't want them to go like this. I want them to go like that. So, they're gonna end up being like this. So that means my hole is gonna be on the left side. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get on center here. The best we can. And it's gonna be 0.45 away from center. On the left. So we'll lock that down. I'm not left-handed. Put it on there. I am not left-handed. And then we're going to take a look at the radius of the hole that needs to be built here. It's pretty thick. So to go into it, I'm going to use a 1/8 inch bit. So all these little holes right here are going to be 0.125. And that is laying out the front panel. We're gonna have to do the top, and we're gonna have to do the back too. And we are not going after what Hiwatt did. We're building our own amplifier. Because one thing that you don't wanna do is get in trouble for copyright infringement. Like, why would you make something exact the same as somebody else made it? I wouldn't. So anyway, that's that. Front panel's done. The next one will be the rear panel, I do believe, and then we'll lay on the top, and then we'll cut all these holes. See ya.